Hello everybody, welcome to a, what is this format? Pioneer, okay. So Pioneer is a new format. Pioneer video, I forgot to say that. Welcome to a Pioneer video. It's a new format that was born a few days ago. A few days ago while I was in Long Beach after the MC5 where I finished third, so definitely good a weekend for me. This new format is born, and it is not legacy. This is very far from legacy. This is in fact a bridge between modern and standard. And it's currently 3 a.m. and I was defeated by the jet lag, and instead of just laying in my bed for hours and hours, I decided to, without sleeping, I decided to just wake up and put up this beautiful Mono Blue Devotion. Mono Blue Devotion is one of my favorite standard deck of all time. I won a PTQ back in, what was it, 2014, and Mono Blue Devotion got some new pieces. I got Tempest Gene mainly, very strong, with Blaster of Waves, and of course, Tassa, God of the Sea. So you just, your devotion to blue is very strong. You play Master of Waves, which is a pretty weird version, but I guess it was cheaper. And on Magical Line, I always get the cheaper version, because I don't really care too much about my digital cards. Brazen Borrower is another new addition, kind of a, you know, both pressure and interaction. Cloud Phoenix Raptor and Siren Storm Teamer are your one drop. You can also play Judge's Familiar, but I'd rather play this. Crew's Obsession also very strong, because we can defend our creature with Dive Down, Spell Pierce, Stubborn Denial, or just, you know, Tassa's Indestructible. That can also just be pretty effective. The mana base is 23 lands, but it's something like 3 Mutavolt and 20 islands. You might wonder, how did you come up with this number, Mengu? So, Karsten mana base says that if you want to play Tempest Gene, you have to play 23 blue sources. But then I asked Javier, I said, Javier, how many Mutavolt should I play? He said 20. He said 3 and 20 lands. And I'm like, okay, nice. I'm gonna trust you without numbers, just because I really like Mutavolt in this deck, back in the days when I was playing Mono Blue Devotion in Standard, and I didn't know that we can use the colorless mana in this deck with Tassa and Master of Waves. There's not that many other ways to use the colorless mana, but I guess those two are enough. Harbinger of Tides is not sure how good it's gonna be. I presume very often we just like top 2 mana to play our Grizzly Bear that helps to attack with Tassa and pumps Master of Waves, but other than that, that's the plan. I'm still not sure what's better between Stubborn Denial, Spam Pierce. I'm just gonna have a variety of those. Temple of Dive Down, just because the format there's Abrupt Decay, and then of course Forker's Obsession, and that's the main deck. Since I would have Leyline of the Void, I'm still unsure, you know, what's the metagame looking like. This might be a very unfair format, so Leyline of the Void never hurts. Then some 6 counter magic. I put Mystical Dispute over Negate because I assume there's gonna be a bunch of blue decks. I don't know. 4 Spell Pierce overall and 3 Stubborn Denial. Rapid Hypnotization is one of the few removals that you can play in blue. There's no Dismember active or you know, anything like that. And then a couple of Jace Architect of Thoughts, which is good against both control and just the Feather Guardian Saheeli combo, as you can plus 1 and they can't kill you with the Feather Guardian. And that's the deck. Let's head down to a Pioneer competitive league, and remember that this video is offered to you by ChannelFireball.com, and you can support both me and ChannelFireball using the link in the description. Round 1, round of play. I'm gonna keep this end. It's pretty land heavy, but I don't know where this can go. Definitely we're gonna draw a card on turn 2. Hopefully, I guess, they can just toss it away. Alright, Watery Grave tapped. Good to see. I don't know why the picture isn't shown. I hope it will be. So let's attack. I'm gonna wait on the land, because if I draw Mutavolt, I could play that. I don't know. I have to consider. So there's a little bit too many lands. So Tassa is not doing much right now. So let's just hope they don't have a removal spell. Although Grixis used to play a removal spell. And in fact, they play a Dreadbore. It is pretty upsetting that they don't have a single picture. I hope the next match I will have them. Alright, so we play our, I don't know, just Cries Every Turn. Hopefully the land go away and we draw spells. Thought the Razor, nice. Take this 4 island. At least they get to scry. Alright, good old Grixis control on the other side. And Blood Crypt tapped. Okay. It's pretty upsetting that there's no picture. I wouldn't know who to blame this for. I'm gonna top this, I think. I'm going to top the spell appears. I honestly don't know if I should top or bottom. You know, of course, I don't know what my opponent's playing and blah blah blah. But my opponent's playing a lot of top lands, so it's very possible that I just get something. I don't get anything here, but I don't know. At least they don't surveil, I guess. There's no fetch land. Oh, there's Royal Summit. Opponent gets slightly punished there. Yeah. All right. Very glad I topped that spell appears, I guess. If they remove a spell, they remove a spell. It's gonna be okay. Or they don't. So I'll pass the turn. Hopefully they have more. Hopefully they have more Discord spells. There's no Snapcaster Mage in the format. We still need to just realize what's in format, what's not. Alright, is this the Scarab God? That would be pretty bad. What is this? Nicol Bolas Dragon God. Sure. Alright. Oh, come on. Where are the pictures? Okay, that's the picture. You draw a card and exile a land from hand. Okay, I would like to draw a spell. I don't even know what at this point. I don't think there's much to save me. Whenever you draw 8 lands. Top 12 cards. Alright. Yeah, I guess that could go. That could work. I'm attacking Nicol Bolas. This way, if they want to kill the Diapas Gene with Nicol Bolas, they have to kill the Nicol Bolas. That's like his unblockability, but it's not relevant in this game, probably. Alright, 4 mana. I'm gonna kill my Tempest Gene. How? Bolas. Wow, Rager. Sure. Yeah. I maybe forgot about the Tassa making unblockable. So the Tempest Gene can kill Nicol Bolas. Siren Storm T-Bur, yeah, I guess that's better than nothing. So I'm gonna gonna cast the Siren Storm Teamer so the Tassa becomes a 5/5 indestructible. Then the Tassa gives unblockability to the Tempest Gene. How do I wanna pay? Probably like this. Yeah, probably like this. And then the Tempest Gene attacks the Bolas and the Tassa attacks face. Tassa is indestructible, remember that? So opponent goes to 8. And now, even if they flip Nicol Bolas and they need a land, they can't reanimate the other Nicol Bolas, I guess. But I have now Siren Storm Teamer if they want to kill my Tempest Gene. Maybe I was supposed to kill my Tempest Gene last turn. I don't know. Okay, I take 6. Take 4 down to 16. They play at land, so now, are they going to go flip it? Maybe I was supposed to just attack face, but then, I don't know. So that's flipped. Like, if they go Nicol Bolas and attempt to kill my Tempest Gene, I'm gonna counter it to the Siren Storm Teamer. And then, I draw a blue card so the Tassa attacks and I kill both of the Planeswalkers. Because Siren Storm Teamer counters spell or ability. I think despite the excessive flood here of drawing 8 lands, maybe we're still in the game. Alright, so we counter that ability. Okay, Scrying Upkeep. Come on, spell. Ay. This was definitely not needed. Definitely not needed. Okay, I can still kill both of the Planeswalker, but would have dealt. Actually, opponent would have been dead. Opponent would have been dead here. Alright, I think I'm going to keep this land in hand. Right? I don't think it does much. I guess if I play it next turn, I can activate it and give 2 unblockability. I can get 2 unblockability regardless. I think I'm gonna leave it as an end. Yeah. Basically, yeah, my opponent would have been dead with any spell there. Pretty funny. I guess a spell pierce or dive down wouldn't have done it either. But with the scry, it was, you know, pretty unlikely to break. Okay, let's see what happens here. Jace Marine's Prodigy, sure. And then they pass. I kind of want to draw, maybe dive down now? I don't know. I think leaving a landing hand is good, just in case they have like a discard spell, maybe a Thoughtseize, they lose 2 life or stuff like that. Mutavault. Spell Pierce. Alright, so unfortunately we can activate our toss again. Sorry, we can't, yeah. Alright, so this is not lethal. I'm still going to pump the Mutavault, I guess. Alright. Sorry, by pump I mean unblockable so that I can't chump block and they go to 1 life. I mean, I have nothing to do with my mana regardless here. Oh yeah, I should have definitely played land last turn in case if I draw land this turn that would have been lethal. Mm-mm-mm. 3 cards in hand for them. What do they have? Hopefully something costs 5. I don't even know what can be. Let me call this command. Discard a card. Alright, so they go to 3 life here. I assume that they can flashback and kill a Tempest Gym with a Dreadbore and then have nothing. But the Jace Frenzy Prodigy, I mean. Yeah. If I don't kill this, they draw 2 cards. And yeah, I just need to kill both of the Planeswalkers, I failed. Yeah, I just need to draw a creature or a spell last turn, that's what was needed. Mm-hmm. So just Telepath Unbound now can maybe flashback opt, or I don't know. Go for the emblem maybe. The emblem says whenever you cast a spell, they're gonna put a minus 5. Dig through time. Yeah, I think that's gonna be enough. Plus, Jace have nothing. These creatures can never attack here. Guess I could have drawn Master of Waves, I don't know. They still had some removals put in the deck. Yeah, maybe I was not supposed to concede there, but you guys know me. Alright, so I'm gonna bring in my creature package. Sorry, my control package, I mean. I guess Curse Obsession can go. Not great against removal spell deck. What else? Maybe that's too many counters. Maybe Leyline is good against them? I don't think so. I do not think so. Maybe Brazen Borrower. So at the end of the day, I'm boarding Jace. I don't want to board out Master of Waves. I think this could be okay. Let's try this. On the play for game 2. I'm keeping this again. Not sure. It's not the best, but toss is definitely the best card in the deck. And having 2 means that it's good against Thought Erasure. Toss a God of the Sea. Alright, Thoughtseize. They go to 16 here. Mm-hmm. I guess if they have Thoughtseize and Thought Erasure, there's nothing they can do about it. Alright, draw step Tempest Gen, sure, I'll tap for 1. Tempest Gen will still evolve the... Oh, sorry, for 0, I'll tap for 1. For some reason I thought this was attacking. Tempest Gen does level up the... Ayayay, so they managed to deal with both of my Tassas. Yeah, this is the problem, play against discard spell deck sometimes. You keep a land heavy hand, they discard your few spells and you have nothing. Alright. We have Master of Waves in our deck. That should be pretty good against them. I guess at this point, at least, if they draw these discard spells, they're dead. So attack for 1, they go to 15. Maybe Clawfiend Raptor is not that good anymore if I play only 6 2 drop. Young Pyromancer. Yep. Again, apologies for the lack of pictures. I don't know what is going on there. It's very tilting, at least for me. I guess one could blame the connection, one could blame the internet. I don't know. Sorry, the Magic Online client. Yes, there's always something to blame. In the meanwhile, opponent just getting beaten down over there. Ooh, Thassa. Yeah, I guess I'll play this first, right? Avoid the Cloud Fiend Raptor, attack me with both. In case my opponent plays something with Flash, I can give that in block ability. Alright, put us on 3 already, and I think that'll do it. Yeah, I'll put my servers in the format, that's cool. M14, right? M14 indeed. Black, black, black. Blue, what's that? Languish? No, Languish? Oh, yeah, Languish is pretty good. Okay, it wasn't Languish at least. Languish would have been pretty brutal. They kill that. Sure. Okay. Any large creature does it. Because I can evolve the Cloud Fiend Raptor. Let's see what we scry. Tempest Gin, that is indeed a large creature. Alright, so we didn't need too much in order to win this game. That was good. I guess 3 Thassa did it. Thassa clearly the best deck, the best card in the deck. Yeah, it's just a bit... I mean, Curious Obsession is nice in everything if you protect it and all the jazz, but I think I'd just rather keep this. Game number 3. Whoa, this one is nice. Just needing lands here. I actually prefer to go right to the left. Yeah, this is how I prefer to lay out my cards for some reasons. Okay, do they have Thoughtseize? Nope. It's good for me. I'll play Siren Storm Teamer. Ooh, land. Exactly what I needed. Land is nice. If they go Thoughtseize, what do they take? Thassa maybe? Ooh, they don't do anything. Okay. Sure. Ooh. Keep this unit as well. Look for one and pass the turn with Merfolk Trickster up. Opponent might even be scared to cast any good card because I have 2 mana up to play. A lot of counters. Also a Merfolk Trickster in this case. Yeah, I'll just play this. I don't want my opponent to... I could also suck the Sandstorm Teamer to counter the Thoughtseize. Because it targets you or creature you control. But man, it's that good at it. Whatever they take. But they very likely just take Thassa because that's just the strongest card by far in my hand. Like, I managed to almost win the game 1 with Thassa despite drawing 8 lands in the first like 12 cards that I drew. Just because of how good Thassa is. Then we managed to break with the scry, but like, Thassa Dea del Mare. So many good memories of this card. This format brings back a lot of good memories. Because the great thing of Standard is that you basically, this is like a great format, but it dies pretty soon. So I really like this new format, that just bringing back old standards, basically. I'm gonna go Tempest Gin here, hopefully they don't have like a Ritual of Sooth language or stuff like that. And if they go like kill my Tempest Gin, sure, you know, that's fine. My hand is just all gas, so I just have to tap mana and cast my things. All right, so what do we do here? Now I'll discard Arbinger of Tides. For sure, though, I can't get through with this unless I trade with Tempest Gin if I draw a land. I think I'll discard Arbiter of Tides. I don't think this card does much. I mean, I could do it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll discard this. Whatever. Alright, let's draw Island. Or Mutavault. Maybe Island is better because it pumps the Tempest Gin. Thassa, God of the Sea. Not bad. Alright, I'll pass the turn. What do they do now? They Thoughtseize me. Okay, they go to 12 here. Master of Waves can be killed by like a fail push, but it's not easy to trigger revolt. There's no fetch lands. It's a Spibble Passage. Okay, I still take Master of Waves. Mm-hmm. And they play a top land. They're on 12. Because they took, you know, a bunch of damage from the Thoughtseize. 3 mana, Radiant Flames. That's a beating. Okay, they killed actually only 2 creatures, not that much of a beating. Okay, here I'm looking for, I don't know, it's literally everything, just not a counter magic. not the countermeasure. That's the only thing that I'm not looking for. Just cost 7 to flip, but they only have 5 lands. Alright, I consider it to attack, but that's not a good attack. I'll just stake and just attack back for a lot of damage. My opponent wouldn't want to trade 4 damage for 3 there. Alright, I'm gonna leave this on top, probably. Yeah, I'll leave this on top. Then I'll play land, I'll play Jace, Architect of Thoughts, activate Tessa. And now, how do I want to attack? This says plus 1 until end of story, blah, 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 blah. Alright, I'm just gonna attack with both. If opponents trade, actually, not as bad to attack with both. So attacking only with Tessa. If opponent trades, the Tessa just becomes bad. So he's gonna attack only with Tessa, I think. Yeah, and then decide what to do with the Jace. So the Jace, if you have plus the Jace, opponent can't really attack to my Tempest Djinn, and even if they want to attack, the Jace still only takes 3 damage, so it goes to 2, and I can just minus 2 later. Yeah, I think I'm gonna plus it. If they go Dreadborn Jace, it's annoying, but I think they would have Dreadboarded the Tempest Djinn if they had it. 2.7, and Tessa. Yeah, you can even unblockable it herself. Such a powerful card. Okay. Yeah, they can't attack here, I just block. Alright, now I want like Stubborn Denial, I guess. Oh, there it is. Okay, what do we do? I gotta go minus 2 here, because if I find land, I'm just unblockable attack. Just taking the 2 spells here, very likely. But we'll put Tempest Djinn alone, I assume. No? Oh, yeah, yeah. Just pile 1 to put in end. Sure. Then I play my land, I give Tessa unblockable. Give Tempest Djinn unblockable, attack with both, and then I Stubborn Denial up. That's why we play that over, you know, I mean, Spell Pierce, I think it's better in the early game, I don't know. But later in the game, Stubborn Denial is just great. Oof. Alright, despite first game loss we got there with the match, let's be back for round number 2. On the play for round number 2, with a solid hand. Turn on Cloudfin Raptor, turn 2, who knows, turn 3, hopefully Tessa. Okay. Alright, we both start on 7 cards. Alright, in case you don't really know how Evolve works, whenever a card just comes into play, both the power, or if the both of the power, whatever, if either of power or toughness is greater, you put a counter on this. So if you play a 0-4, it gets a counter. If you play a 2-2, it gets a counter. You know, it's just so on and so forth. Okay, Spark Bluff Canal. Mm-hmm. I'll probably just play a Siren Storm Teamer. This way I can evolve this Cloudfin Raptor twice. Because now, this is 1 power and this is at 0, right? And then next turn we play Merfolk Trickster. And then, I don't know, we'll see. We will see for sure. So I take a damage and I'll pass. Opt. I prefer honestly Ixalan Opt to the Dominaria one, but I guess. Also don't like too much the 8th edition. Okay, Storm Chaser Mage. Sure, maybe my opponent is playing some sort of blue red Delver. Without Delver. Delverless Delver, as they call it. Ooh, Curse Obsession. Okay, let's cast it on this. And attack. Maybe I was wrong, I should have put it there. Or at least I should have played the Trickster first. I don't know, I just wanted to tap the Storm Chaser Mage. But this way I'm not gonna evolve the Cloudfin Raptor. Alright, play Swift Spear. Okay, they're shocking the Siren Storm Teamer. Shock. Pretty sad to play Shock. Alright, so let's stop that. Let's did. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, I have a stop. I don't know why I have a stop in the main phase. I guess it was some Legion War Boss previous video. Mono Red. Playing against some Mono Red. Okay, also I'll tap the Storm Chaser Mage. Just in case they want to leave it black to block my Trickster. Ooh, Wizard's Lightning, wow. That's a beating. Okay. Although if I draw a land, just slime a Master of Waste, that should be good, right? Protection from red. Three tokens elemental. This is protection from red, so just block the monastery swift spear. If they manage to bounce this, my elemental dies, but next turn just gem another one. Mm-hmm, so a bunch of flyers. Yeah, it's looking pretty good here. Master of Waves showing the power. Okay, what are this shocking? Okay. Let's shock that. Mm-hmm, so I got a 12. They have zero cards in hand. So, if I gem a Master of Waves, I only put two tokens. I guess I can just, I don't know, play a Tempest Djinn. And attack with these horses. Yeah, I just offer my opponent a trade if they want to take it. I think they don't know about the second Master of Waves. Alright, yeah, this is gonna be lethal. Very likely. Right? This is just too many elementals, and also the pumps these three. Because all the elemental gets +1/+1. Mm-hmm, you're going to win. So I'm playing as Blue-Red Delver. Sorry, Blue-Red Wizard. Still, Dispute could be fine. Spell Push and Stubborn Denial looks pretty good. I might just board out the Curse Obsession again. Maybe this is for the combo decks, but there's not that many combo decks. Yeah. I think I wanna do this. Could have Mystical Dispute as well. They didn't show me that many good cards. Maybe they have Cruise, but they might cast Cruise later in the game when they have blue up, when they have three up. I might board in too many. No, this is too many. This is definitely too many counterspell. Just have to understand which is better though. Probably Spell Burst is better in this matchup. Maybe Mystical Dispute is okay, in fact. Just because it counters the creature as well. And then I'm gonna board in, I don't know, one removal spell. Let's go with this. This end is not very strong. Little Mulligan, it doesn't have any good card. Alright, had I known, I would have had this, and I probably wouldn't have Mulligan. Alright, I'm gonna put that to the bottom, and what else? Probably just a Spell Pierce. I don't want to put two Master Waves to the bottom. I think that is a way to get back into the game after this Mulligan to 5. Mm-hmm, nice start. Land Swift Spear. My answer with a Land 0-1. And then a Storm Chaser Mage. Okay, that's a good start for my opponent. Alright, I'm gonna concede. Okay. Yeah, I think three Spell Priests are enough. I guess four. I have four right now. Just that they play Shock, Wizard's Light. It's just too many Grimoire Spell Duplicator's Obsession, I think. Yeah, maybe just one Jace. I don't think so. My opponent could also have some like ways of permission, like some Spell Priests and stuff. Let's just go with this. On the play. Ay. Zen is not great. I'm still gonna keep it because I have Tassa, but hopefully I draw a 2 drop right now. Okay, no 1 drop from my opponent, that's good. When I had one of the previous draw, it would have been maybe too hard to deal with. Mm-hmm. Storm Chaser Mage, attacks for 1. Right on time with the Cloudfinger Raptor. So I'm gonna go Tassa here. I think if I curve Tassa into Master of Waves, maybe there's a chance. Or just start scrying land to the bottom is a good thing. Spell Pierce. I think they have a counter. They might really have a counter. So I play Cloudfinger Raptor and pass, so I just cast Master of Waves with Spell Pierce up. Although if they have Mystical Dispute, I still can't Spell Pierce that. Magmatic Insight. Oh wow. I've seen this card before, but wow, good on my opponent to figure that card still exists. Okay, now I can beat a Mystical Dispute though. What do they do, ninjutsu? Wild Lash. Do I play around Mystical Dispute? I think I do. I don't even know if Mystical Dispute is in my opponent deck, but I think I do. Sure. Is this like a better shock? Yeah, it's just a better shock. Alright. Dive down. Sure, so let's play Master Waves, playing around Mystical Dispute, which my opponent doesn't have, and then I'll pass with my couple of elementals. Yeah, I just think that if I resolve Master Waves in a very good spot, so I just wanted to leave Spell Pierce up in case they had, you know, what I am actually playing around. Sometimes you just, you know, put your hand around something, and my opponent just doesn't have it, just might even not even play. Okay, what are they doing? Yeah, sure. So they're burning me. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I got a 10, attack for 3, I got a 7. What's this now? Treasure Cruise. Okay, Treasure Cruise. Alright, go to 6. And then, if I draw Tempest Gin, it's good. Come on, Tempest Gin. Tempest Gin? Merfolk Trickster. Wow, that's a good draw. Sure, I'll just attack and pass. I might even go upkeep Merfolk Trickster. Yeah, I'll go upkeep Merfolk Trickster. So that my opponent doesn't draw counter magic. I guess this way though, they don't play creature spells pre-combat. So maybe that was wrong. Blazing Volley. I could save one of the elemental. Because this is protected for red, so it doesn't die. Yeah, I think I'm gonna save an elemental. I don't even know, what am I doing with this dive down? Yeah. Alright. Do I draw a spell? Nope. I don't have any flyers, so I just attack. And I'll play a land and pass. Opponent is on 8. I'm on 6. If opponent is double burn spell, I die. Even double shock is lethal. Let's see what happens. Why they don't attack, very good news. Okay. Brazen Barber. Sure. I'm going to probably play Petty Theft first. And then I'll cast a Brazen Barber. Making Thass a creature and attacking for, I don't know, 11. This could even block the Storm Chaser Mage. Right, do they have a shock for my trickster? It's still lethal. Wild Lash there. Sure. Sure, okay, so I'm gonna survive one more turn. Maybe I was supposed to not go for lethal here. Just leave the Prison Barber to bounce the Star Storm Chaser in my opponent's turn. Because now I could lose in case they have a, I don't know, double burn spell. I'll opt, okay. Alright, now Wizard's Lightning is lethal. Alright, don't top it, please. Because if you top, I'd be very upset. Because it could have just Petty Theft in your turn. Alright, so land. Do you have a Wizard's Lightning? Nope, they say GG. Or maybe they do. Cruise, okay. Alright. 2-0. Let's be back for round number 3, but before that, I remind you to visit ChannelFireball.com and you can buy all these cool new Pioneer cards on the website. Unless they're already sold out, because, you know, Tassa is not really a card to have in stock. For example, Magic Online, Tassa was completely sold out. I had to wait like 15 minutes in like all the bots to get them. Although I do have my form, because I never sell any card in paper. All right, so yeah, that's basically what I was saying. ChannelFireball.com can trade with you with a 30% store credit bonus, or you can just buy cards from there using the link in the description, and see you for round number three. All right, mulligan. Keep. What do we bottom? Is it going to be a... maybe a dive down. I just want to have a critical amount. A mass amount of creatures. Okay, Fabled Passage. Ay ay ay. This mutable now come to bite me. After being very strong in game one against Grixis control, they are now coming to bite me. Remember, 20 islands, 3 mutables. That's a ratio that I decided to put in my deck. Oh, young peasy. Okay. I'll probably just trade if opponent wants to. I don't know. Master of Waves is definitely a great pickup. If I draw an island next turn, I might just win on behalf of just Master of Waves itself. Man, this card apparently is pretty popular. Maybe someone wrote about it, because I haven't seen this card. When is this? When do Magic Charge is from? Doesn't say. Whatever. So I shock the Storm Teamer and they attack for 2. I go to 18. Alright, can I draw Island, please? Island? Island. Island. Nice. Okay. So I could play Murphic Trisker pre-combat, or I could just maybe pass. I don't want to attack for 1. I guess I shouldn't pass here. I should definitely attack. No, I should pass here, yeah. Opponent attacks here, I can just make it such a big ambush. Alright, well, no. Okay. Oof, I was about to F6. If they go shock on my Cloudfear Raptor. I mean, I F6, actually. If they go shock on my Cloudfear Raptor, now I can go Merfolk Trickster to save it. Alright, what do they do? Hopefully they start off with a shock on the Cloudfear Raptor to free the Elementals. Wow. Fiery Impulse. Yeah, so that's the Edory. Is there two more? Yep. My dive down's on the bottom. Although, not that I wanted to. Also, my opponent can't really. I mean, if they attack, I'm going to activate the Mutavolt. Alright. I didn't want to just play this pre combat. I guess I could have played this pre combat, but in case this worked, I would have eaten Elemental. I don't know. It's very likely I'm putting it just as a burn spell. I'll put it just mono burn spell in their deck. Yeah, I mean, this Master Waste is not going to be the greatest. I should have just played the Trickster pre-combat, I guess. Okay, they have 3 cards in end. Hopefully they don't go Cruise now, please. Not go Treasure Cruise. Oh, yes. Okay, Soul Scar Mage. Okay, I'm trying to just put more Elementals. If I just go Master Waves here, I don't think this can ever win. So I'm just going to go Trickster. Free combat. Arclight Phoenix. Okay. I'm very dead this game. They just attack with everything. Even with this? Wow. I might even trade Mountain for Mutable for Young Pyromancer just to avoid 2 damage. Yeah, this doesn't seem like a good attack. Oh yeah, the tokens attack? No, it's okay, let's just pass. Alright, I would like to draw a... I don't know, I don't even think... I think it's just a 1 drop now. Like... a Cloud Queen Raptor. Okay, could do something. So play that, pass the turn, put it as an Arclight Phoenix, which you don't have an answer for. It's a lot of tokens. Arclight Phoenix, interesting, very interesting. Opponent's deck is very nice, top. Master Waves is stopping alone. All this board. Siren Storm Teamer is my draw. And I play my second Master of Waves. So So now I put, I don't even know how many tokens, but a lot of tokens, and all are very large. I could see attacking with all here. Even with the Trickster. I just double the Elementals back. Yeah, I don't need the Master of Reuses back. I think I need to race here. I think this race is pretty good. Remember protection from red. I think I've said it 20 times, but I think it's good to remember. How does it feel to play a 4-mana 2-1 that's a lord for your board and puts 5 3-2s into play and is protected from the color of your opponents? It's pretty good, right? Okay, so if they go, just kill my elementals with some double blocks of the elementals. Hopefully they don't have a spell to go close. Yeah, they do have a spell, I think. Otherwise they would have. Oh, they don't. Okay. They're gonna put Soulscar Mage first. I just hope they don't have a spell. If they had a spell, they wouldn't have done this, I think. Just gave me the option, it's pretty bad, so. Okay, so we successfully killed all my opponent. Almost all my. Almost all my opponent creatures. Mm-hmm. 13 to 10. And they have two Mutavolt sitting there. So, you know, I said that the Mutavolt came back to bite me, but now they're probably gonna be, you know, actual something. Third Master of Waves would be great. Alright, I'm not gonna jump block just yet. Maybe later I will. But now I feel like I just wanna tap with Siren Storm Teamer. Ooh, they don't do anything. Cuffing Raptor, it's basically not a draw step. So I think I'm going to just fire off my Mutavolt attack with all and just leave that up. The Siren Storm Teamer up. Maybe even with the Siren Storm. Wow, this is an elemental, I forgot about it. Yes, the combo. The Mutavolt is any kind of creature. Oh my. Alright, I might just attack with the Siren Storm Teamer as well. Just because of ChannelFireball Raptor to jump block later. I could just lead back double block, double creatures. Okay, so if they block 3, 1, 2, 3, they take 3, 6, 9, 12. That's just infinite damage. Just send a team. Opponent's dead here. Unless they have, like, I don't know, Echoing Truth on my Master of Waves, but I do have the Siren Storm Teamer up. So yeah, pretty great how my opponent drew. I don't know, kind of felt like a legacy deck, but just back to back Master of Waves was enough to steal the win here. Okay, so what are they shocking? The Siren Storm Teamer. Sure. Maybe it was a greedy attack? I don't know. Probably. I do have a, you know, a backup Cloud Phoenix Raptor here to chump block the Arclight Phoenix. That's just too much damage. Yeah, they keep on 9 plus 4. That's just still 13, so they have to chump block one more. One more horse. I say horse because that's a picture of a horse, but it isn't a horse, it's an elemental. And get pumped by this. So they have to chump one more. Come on, young Pyromancer, don't hesitate. Don't hesitate, come into the sea. Take a swim into my elemental. Alright, so everything dies. I'll play a 0-1 and pass the turn. Okay, that's gonna be it. That's gonna be it. Good job, Master of Waves. Alright, so still unclear how to sideboard in this matchup. Still unclear. Mystical Dispute, I think it's okay. They do have a bunch of blue cards. And I think Stubborn Denial can go out. Yeah, I think I'm gonna board in the Curious Obsession out, but I just have so many removal spells. I don't think I can ever fight with that, with my counter magic or, you know, dive down and such. Let's go with this. Alright. This end is not very good. I think I'm gonna keep it, but this end is not very good. Could easily see myself losing with this hand. Mountain, Swift Spear. Let's get in. Islands from Team or go. Okay, yeah, I would love to stop drawing islands, if that's possible. It'll light up a stage. Chart a course. Yeah, it's basically light up a stage. Okay, I drew the best card in my deck. In this matchup, at least. Chart a course. I would have loved to. I didn't know they would have gone chart a course. I would have spell pierced that for sure. Don't know what chart a course is. You might remember you with a picture. Without the picture? No, it's a picture. Okay. Yeah, I guess. I don't even know if this is connection or Magic Online. I don't know where to draw the line. Think in the ice. Mm-hmm. I think I'm going to bounce that. Yeah, I just don't do much with my mana this turn, so I'm gonna play that regardless. So I could leave that for Thing in the Eyes, but I just felt that I wanted to play this and I'd rather save one life than, I don't know, nothing. Two mana maybe. Yeah, that would have been better, I don't know. I'll attack and pass and then I'll play Brazen Borrower end of turn. Wolfenbund doesn't play four spells next turn. There's no new pure action in format, thankfully. One of the strongest set of all time, for sure. Fiery Impulse. Yeah, I'm not gonna go spell pierce here. I wanna just curve out Brazen Barber Master Waves. I guess I could've just bounced this. I don't know. Fable Buzz is just strange in my opponent's deck. I guess it does graveyard for Treasure Cruise, but my opponent's mana base doesn't really want an Evolving Wilds. And you might say, yeah, but now it's not Evolving Wilds. Sure. But 4 mana is still a lot. Sorry for the yawning. It's still 4 a.m. Monster Assist here. 4 cards in end. Mm-hmm. Chart a course. I think I'm still not gonna do anything. I guess they will, maybe. Cause I just want to, no, I think I'm not gonna do anything here. I'm just gonna play this and pass. Yeah, I guess I should have waited for them to discard a card, but whatever. I just wanted to get over with the clicks. Okay, I go to 14 here. Okay, that's too many lands. Not even Mutavault, unfortunately. So 3 tokens attack. If my opponent bounces here, I mean, I guess I lose because I take like a lot of damage maybe, but I just rebuild. I can just rebuild next turn. It's not it. I'm very close to just taking to take lethal if opponent bounces the thing in the ice. Mm-hmm, that's a good start. Pretty incredible how Treasure Cruise is in the format. Pretty incredible. One of the, you know, strongest designed card of last probably 5 years. Didn't know what's Concept Arc here. I guess it was 2015, I think. Okay, so things got bounced. I'll put in this to make a land drop, so that could be 8 damage coming in next turn. I'm not even paying attention how this cries. Very irrelevant at this point. Okay, go to 6 here. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna go Petty Theft immediately. And then, I don't know, very unlikely to win. Opponent has 8 cards in hand. Alright, I'm not even gonna try to fight this. Let's just save everybody's time. Opponent did, you know, well. Definitely need a dismember in this deck. But unfortunately there isn't. Maybe Rapid Hybridization is needed. I guess I'm gonna have only 3 spell pierces. Yeah, let's go with this. At the end, I decided to board in the last. Oh my, did I just submit 14 cards in my sideboard in this league? That's strange. So there's 60 cards in my deck. Oh, no, it's 15. Okay. Yeah, for some reason, I thought it was 14. All right, would you like to play first? Yes, I would. Sure. I think Rapid Hybridization is just needed if your opponent has a Thing in the Ice in the deck. I just felt that way when I was playing Ogak against Lure Thing in the Ice. I practiced that matchup a lot because I was testing with Avir.
one of the, you know, best thing in the S player ever. I mean, we're playing with Phoenix, which now is dead, but you know, it used to be a thing. And Hosogak is dead, and also used to be a thing. Oh, pretty crazy how the PT was like, I don't know, 3 months ago, and they banned basically every card in that format. And they banned the format as well. Alright, so Fable Passage. Okay. I like to draw a land here if it's possible. I don't even know if I'm a Brazen Borrower, if they play like a 1-3 haste. They play Pyromancer, I'm gonna just bounce it. I think it's more relevant to bounce it than just play a 2-2. Alright, can I draw an island? Please, island. It's a big beating. Okay, I can see the game slipping away now. Missing a drop here is huge. Huge. Alright. Okay, we're back. Back on track. Also, my opponent missed a land drop. I'll play my huge. Tempaging is amazing in this matchup. They only have like 2 or 3 damage spells. And they're mana screwed right now. Okay, what did I do? Lava Coil? Hopefully not. Is there a most buff for my Tempaging? Cathartic Reunion 2? I played Phoenix? What? Alright. I'm just gonna go Master of Waves here. I think it's just... yeah, just no reason not to. But I can't counter this. There's no dates. And then this is unbeatable. I just attack with both. I think the Arcade Phoenix cannot raise the Master of Waves here. Alright, so lucky to draw back-to-back land here. So lucky to draw back-to-back lands. Because Malfurk Trickster, Master of Waves, Tempest Gen, I think does it. Putting six horses into play. Did my opponent go for the good old, I can't beat this, so I'm gonna just go away from keyboard. Instead of conceding. It might be. I just don't want to say anything bad about my opponent. Alright, I didn't. That were just, I don't know, reading cards, I guess. Okay. So that's attack. That also deserves a screenshot, I think. It's pretty good board. I really like it. Really like it, this board state. Alright. But this is in 12. They could reanimate double arc like Phoenix, but I think at this point I can long lose. Even a rapid urbanization just in case. Mm-hmm. Just in case. Although the elementals do get blocked by the other elementals as well. It's mono elementals. Whose elementals are cooler? The burn one, the fire one, or the water one? Feels like Pokemon. What was the Pokemon that... Eevee, right? Yeah, Eevee. So the elementals are basically Eevee. Where they're things, and then whatever you put together, they're just happy and just join. So if you put fire, they just become this. If you put water, they become a horse. I don't even know how to call this. Alright, go Lightning Axe. Oh, wow, Lightning Axe. So they actually managed to randomly double Arcanine Phoenix. Wow, I did not expect this turn from my opponent. That was an amazing turn from my opponent. Mm-hmm. So I go to 14. I drop Brazen Borrower. Sure. Unfortunately, I don't have another Master of Waves. That would have been good. What do I do here? If I attack with all, they go 4 of these block. And then they take 2, 4, 6. So I go to 6. I think that's good. I think that is good. And then I'm going to... I'm not sure. Probably just play Tempest Gen and pass. Maybe playing these two, maybe. Yeah, I think I'll play these two. Okay. The last row is... could just go all the way up. Ooh, Treasure Cruise, wow. Yeah, definitely underrated my opponent power to just win this game despite my super good curve here. Crash through. Wow, crash through. Did not expect to see that. Okay, I'm still 14 and they are in 6, potentially 4. So, and they have a bounce spell. Unfortunately, they have no trample creatures. But yeah, Master Wave's definitely got countered pretty hard. Wow, Steam Vents. So I didn't draw a single land. It's pretty unlucky. Oh, gets tapped. Okay. Wow. All the cards now, they just play a tap land. Okay, they passed the turn. Tassa God of the Sea. Tassa God of the Sea. I mean, they also just kill the two flyer. Right, just bounce the Arclight Phoenix. Rapid appreciation, the other Arclight Phoenix attack for 6 in the air. I mean, there's no way my opponent can beat this because they have Siren up. I guess a Spell Pierce can beat it. Let's see. Let's see if they have it. So if they go counter magic, okay, they don't, and then they have no out. 6 damage, GG. All right, good game. Oof. Oof, oof, oof. Oop. All right, that was a mistake. Oh, merda. Okay, that's a mistake. All right, hopefully we will survive to it. Although it seems very hard. I guess just throw away my game. My apologies. My apologies. All right, so they're gonna ram it 2 Phoenixes and I mean, at that attack with a certain Storm Teamer, I could have just drawn with the land, I'd probably still win. And that with Terran Storm Teamer, it would have been a 1, so even if they kill one of my creatures, the Tassa would have still been lethal, but... Sorry, the line would have still been lethal on Tassa, but... Alright, so third spell, what is going to be just a burn spell on my Terran Storm Teamer, I guess. Mm-hmm. Alright, come on, land. Come on, land, to not get punished, despite playing very bad. Alright, land. Let's put stop in upkeep because I need to focus more. Alright. Okay, guys, I need to focus. And, you know the rule of Magic the Gathering, like, play well, get rewarded. It doesn't work. It's not. It doesn't work. It just doesn't really matter. Anything you do, it's not related to the future. So we're gonna draw a island and win the game. Yes, Mengu. Yes, Mengu. 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 All right. That's God of the Sea. Get it in. Oof. Oof, oof, oof. 3-0. This time 3-0 for real. I announced the 3-0 the last turn where top opponent had a green creature against my Master of Waves. But this time around, oof, my opponent did really, really well this game. I did not expect them to come back. On turn 2, they played Young Peasy. I missed a land drop, but they also missed a land drop. So I thought that once they drew land to play Tempest Gin and Master Waves, that game was over. But definitely turned the game back around. And I mean, had I not chump attack with the Master of Waves, maybe I would have won even if I didn't top deck land this turn. But, you know, that definitely helped. All right, 3-0. Oof, oof, oof. Let's go back. Around the play with a mulligan. I'd be curious, obsession shouldn't be in the deck. I don't know. I mean, now that I said it, maybe I'm just gonna win with it. Alright, so we keep this hand. Bottom, I think Merfolk Trickster. You might say, but Mengu, you don't have any land. Bottom some 4 drops. No, that's not how it works. That's not how it works. You don't have to bottom 4 drop and keep bad 2 drops if you mulligan down. You need to just keep the good cards, develop a good game, and now my game is to just draw one land, nope, to attack, get island so I can kill my opponent, counter my opponent, bounce spell or a kill spell. Island is important to your deck. It's very important. Thank you. And then hopefully I just take the game away with this Cloudfin Raptor. And then even if I don't, you know, I just have this Tatsa and Master Waves to win the game with later. Portitao, wow. I was a wonder. Whenever Spirit comes into play. Mm-hmm, okay. Alright. Let's play Curse Obsession now. So that I spell Pierce playing around Muzzling Wonder. To attack for two, draw a card, draw two cards. Unless they want to sacrifice their creature. Spectra Sailor. Uh-huh. Oh my. Oh no. Super sad Mengu right now. The saddest. Just the saddest. Should I play Spectra Sailor in my deck? Maybe. Maybe Cloudfin Raptor is obsolete. Maybe Curse Obsession is bad. I don't know. We've boarded out three times and in this game I just didn't. It just wasn't good. Alright, let's play the God of the Sea and get Spell Quellered. Spell Queller. Nice, there it is. Spell Queller, mm-hmm. Those are Drug Skull Captain. Smuggler's Copter. Yeah, I'm not playing Smuggler's Copter either. I don't know if that was right or wrong. Okay, so I just play Tempest Gin. That way, the Smuggler's Copter can't attack, basically, unless I deal with my Tempest Gin. Sure. Maybe, you know, Spectre is a good way to just flood with this deck. Because this deck does flood a lot. Teferi. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, okay, I'll give up. Alright, put it into definitely give me a beating. I might get to 6 on the play, and I got destroyed there, so I think it's okay if I give up. Alright, Mystical Dispute comes in. I don't know if I want anything else here. I think I'll keep the Curse Obsession in my deck. What do I want to cut? I don't know. I don't want to cut creatures. I just board 2 for 2. Just call it like this. Okay. On the play. Another mulligan for Mengu. Okay. Skip this. I think our friend Merfolk Trickster, actually, maybe our friend Cloudfin Raptor goes. I don't know, what am I going to do here? I'll play Cloudfin Raptor turn 1. No, I think a friend Merfolk Trickster actually goes here. I go turn 1 Cloudfin Raptor, turn 2 Curse Obsessions. No, I go, yeah, this goes. So I go down. Let's start. Next turn, I'm just gonna probably just go Siren Storm Teamer Curse Obsession. I don't think my opponent can deal with it on turn 2. Maybe they can, but I'm just gonna play around the fairy here. Alright. Spell Pierce. Plow. Nothing. Turn off auto yield. Alright, land, thank you. Nope. Alright, this time the mana did not work out. The one lander did not work out. Although sometimes we might be allowed to draw more than one land. Alright. They don't attack, but I'm just gonna do this. Whatever, they're just gonna chump block if they don't have any. Rattle Chain? Sure. At the end of the day, this is okay. Like, at this time, we traded. You know, because I cantripped once, and the problem is that I don't have land. So it doesn't really matter if you cantrip or not. Alright, it's gonna save time and give it a concede, and we'll be back for round number 5. I want to make this video fast. Alright, that's good. I've never drawn a Bridger of Tides yet. Totsies. Maybe, I don't know. Swamp Totsies, Swamp Pockrat. That was usually what you were facing. very often in standard those days. Swamp Thoughtseize, Swamp Pack Rat. I think it's very viable in this format still. Actually, maybe not. And I played against two blue red decks, so. Pack Rat is not very good against the deck with Shaw, Fiery Impulse, Wise Lash, so on and so forth. Wizard's Lining. Alright, don't play Pack Rat. Obviously, can't beat Pack Rat now. I mean, maybe there's a line where we eventually kill them, race them with Tempest Djinn and bouncing the token with Harbinger, but. And Merfolk Trickster. Doesn't bounce, it just takes time. Okay, BG. Green Flayer. Oh wow, Mog Fanatic. Nice. Okay, land is very well accepted. I'm gonna pass the turn with Trickster up. Just gonna Overgrown Tomb, take 2 damage. Take pay 3, Courser of Crucifix. Sure. Decay on top. Okay. The Kiddo cannot kill Thassa, the God of the Sea. Because the God of the Sea is too strong. Too strong indeed. Indestructible, that's why. Alright, I could also bounce the Courser of Crucifix, but I just don't think that's. I just want to lay down my Thassa. And next turn, maybe go Tempest Djinn, attack with Thassa. If I draw land, I can go dive down to protect my Tempest Djinn. And then the race is on my side very, very much. Alright, black, green. What is this? Tireless Tracker, Liliana of the Veil. Sorry, of the Last Hope. Yep, we have the Last Hope. They can kill my Merfolk Trickster here. I think they do it. Yep. Okay, so now that line is gone, but I can still scry. Definitely not this. Is this a Motobug? Yes, it was. Alright. So we cast an Harbinger of Tides, I think. And then I pass. I don't want to play Tempest Djinn into Abrupt Decay. Alright, thankful opponent keeps on breaking on land. They minus 2. Okay, they really want to hit the land drop. And they do. Very good for them. Very good for them. Woodland Cemetery off the top. Alright, let's draw land, shall we? More lands for them. So they got back Grim Flayer, okay. And they also have Delirium. Oh no, they're missing one piece for Delirium. Okay, let's draw land. Nice. So I got Tempest Djinn. Now with Thassa, attack Liliana. To go fatal push on my Harbinger, it's annoying. They know about my dive down. It is, in fact, a fail push on my Harbinger. Ugh, it's annoying because if I go dive down, sure, you know, I get this attack and blah blah blah. But then they kill my Tempest Djinn. With an Abrupt Decay. I don't think I want to kill this. I think I'll let it go past the turn. And now I just have like my Tempest Djinns will just grind my opponent through. That's a good card on top too. So I'm gonna give him one more life. Next turn I'm gonna play second Tempest Djinn. I want to kill the Liliana so that my Siren Storm Teamer could be an extra removal spell. Sorry, counter magic. Wait on their hand. Their hand is Overgrown Tomb, Grim Flayer, Abrupt Decay, and another card I don't remember. But it wasn't a spell. A land, sorry. It was a fatal push. Maybe I should have played around it last turn. I don't remember. I don't remember what was the last card that they revealed. Anyway, this game is definitely cool and interesting. Thassa, God of the Sea, will do well. I don't think I will land anymore here. Although next turn I can't cast my hand if I draw land. But I'm not that interested in casting Siren Storm Teamer without protection up. So I'd rather just bottom for a spell. Mm-mm. Alright, opponent, what do you do? What do you do? Very, very tough game. Definitely, definitely hard. Black and green. Still a viable strategy. Are they in delirium? They are. Oh, no, they're not. Alright, two instant. The Grim Flayer is still a 2-2. Feels like I'm playing as Nassif right now. At the Witch, at the Mythic Championship. There was a feeling where I was... wow, they minused. Uh-huh. Scavenging Goose on top. They get back Walking Ballista, okay. And they play what? Uh-huh. So we're going to gain... yeah, nothing. To go even. And then they can abruptly K my Tempest Gen. Sure, so let's cry. Trickster. It's pretty bad. It's just pretty bad overall. Maybe a land is even better. Do I want to play Siren Storm Teamer or dive down? I think I'll play Siren Storm Teamer. I mean, it's not that one or the other, it's just... I think it's good if I just play this first. Alright, to go to K, I'm gonna go dive down. Alright, attack for 10. They might chomp block one of these. Mm-hmm. So that's just 2 Tempest Gen on the into play. Opponent's on 10. I think despite my opponent's all the most one, I'm gonna keep the Curse Obsession. Just because if I have also opponent's a lot of spells, I think I'm gonna bring in some spell pierces. Alright. Walking Ballista to kill my Storm Teamer. Mm-hmm. And then they go up Rapid Decay on the Tempest Gen. That could be good, although. Oh, wait, what's this? Oh, they're dead. Maybe it forgot what Tassa does. Which is fine, I mean, Tassa's like literally 20,000 ability. You might wonder, wait, can give him block ability to herself as well? Yes, even to herself. I mean, a land would have been lethal, but whatever. I guess I should have just played land to show my opponent if they didn't know what the card does. I could have gotten an edge there. Alright. So what do we want to sideboard out? With Prison Bar, I guess Flyers are super good. Maybe Master of Waves. Maybe Master of Waves is not great, although they have, what, Pop Final Push, Abrupt Decay, yeah, those things do not kill that. I think I'm gonna board out Prison Barber, and I could board out... maybe, I don't know what's better, Stubborn Nail Spell Pierce. I don't know what to do, guys. I think I'm just gonna have only Chase. Yeah. Maybe not even Chase, just have only the protection plan up. Oh, whatever, let's try this. Maybe we change for game number 3. Game number 2 against Black Green. Gonna keep this pretty bad end. Alright, I don't know what thoughts is at least. Maybe we're supposed to board this out? I don't know. If I start boarding Sarah from Teamer out though, the Curse Obsession gets worse because Sarah's Teamer is bad against Liliana. So ideally, we just go something like Counter Magic? I don't know. Get to go to Leandro's Veil now. Oh, the Last Hope now, I feel like super bad. Ooh, attack is risky. Alright, I don't have it. Don't go Liliana. Corsair, okay. Mm, I'm gonna go Tempest Gen and pass. Let's see. It's going to happen. Let's see what's going to happen. Alright, Scavenging Ooze. Wyvern Tomb. Tapped, wow. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, Queer's Obsession. That's interesting. So I can go Harbinger of Tides on this now. What can I do? I'll probably just attack and play Jace Architect of Thoughts. Plus, pass. Them having Walking Ballista in play means that, I don't know, can't really freely. Did I play land from top and it was the same? No, I feel like they played a Swamp from hand. Alright, they played Kalithas. Ay. Kalithas is pretty good here. They can shoot down my Sandstorm Teamer and make a zombie. Make two zombies? Whenever an opponent creatures, right? Yeah. If the non-token creature an opponent control gets would die, they'll exile it. And it is a 3-4 lifelink. That can get even larger. So I assume I'm gonna lose this game. Mm-hmm, so I do the thing. They do the thing. Fail push. Alright, I think it's fine. Let's go to game number 3. Where I will maybe have rapid hybridization. I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think so. Okay, final game of the league. Keep this hand, hoping to draw a Curse Obsession. And run a game with the game. Run away with the game. Overgrown Tomb tapped. Okay, so no thoughts is again. Curse Obsession. Alright. I'll probably play this just to level up 2 times the Cloud Fiend Raptor. If I just play Harbinger of Tides, then the Sandstorm Teamer doesn't level up the Raptor. Alright, land please. Nice, so I just cast this. Put a counter on the Raptor, attack for 3. Mm-hmm. And I'll go dive down here for sure, whatever it is. Yeah, but I maybe should have gone Abrupt Decay in their turn. Usually the Abrupt Decay is uncounterable in Legacy, for example, but other formats could play weird cards like Dive Down or, I don't know, land again. Land again, please. Okay, this time they don't want to make me untap. Feel to push my Raptor, land. Thassa, God of the Sea, pretty good. Alright, let's play the God of the Sea, and now we're gonna hopefully scry land next turn on top, and then my hand is very gas. Okay, dude, I never removal spell, very good. Fabled Passage. Very popular deadland, I did not expect to see deadland to be this popular. Kalithas, there it is. Land top. Master Waves will give me the thing, so I think I'm gonna just go for Master of Waves in this board. Not sure, maybe it was wrong. Not sure, maybe it was wrong, because if I have 5 mana, I can protect it with Sandstorm Teamer, the Master of Waves. But again, there's not that many answers for the Master of Waves in my opponent's deck. Not sure, they're gonna go Fable Passage, Fatal Push, but I don't know, they're gonna go like Master Impulse, but it's not the main problem in this board, is Tassa, the God of the Sea. Although they go Zombie with the Kalithas, I don't know, maybe Kalithas can just turn this game away. I mean, it's not maybe, it's very likely that Kalithas does turn this game away. Now, I would say I'm still slightly ahead, but if I could see my opponent's hand, that could definitely be behind if opponent has good cards here. Jace Architect of Thoughts could have been Petty Theft. If it was Petty Theft, it would be much better. Well, I'm not sure what would my play be. It's probably still play Master of Waves, just to attack with Tassa. Alright, I play a black. What is it? They need... I don't know if they kill need to kill the Master of Waves. Maybe not. Just to go Cursor of Crucifix. Land. I don't know. Sounds like a little Assassin's Trophy, I guess. Whatever they do, they want to do it now so they're on top with Center Storm Teamer up. Definitely tough choices. Okay, they got Thoughtseize on themselves. Oh my.
Yeah, look at what they're doing. The Thoughtseize themselves to go get. To go Thought. Traverse the Wall to get Walking Ballista and shoot down my Master of Waves. Sure, it's fancy. That does it. Guess I'm glad I played Master of Waves then. Yep. So I got a.
So if I draw. Alright. Let's see what I scry. Alright, that was it's pretty good.
Okay, so we attack for 6, and do I want to also give them the trade here? No, I don't, definitely don't. If I trade, I just remake another zombie with the Kalitas. So I just let them champ block. They go to 7, and they have an abrupt decay, and they have a lot of creatures. Basically, you know, same as last turn. So, as you can see, Master Waves is very much needed in this deck, I think. Okay, looks like they said GG. Alright, GG. Sure. Okay. That's it. Went 4-1. Got easily defeated by Blue White, but I guess I never hit the second land drop on turn 2 in that matchup. Okay, I'm very glad with the deck. Tassa Master Waves will be what I want to do in this format the few times that I'll play it, I guess. Tempest Gym looks great. I don't know about Curse Obsession. I don't know about the Stubborn Denial Spell Pierce ratio. I didn't even know about the Cloudfinger Raptor. I mean, this deck is definitely, there's a lot of room to explore. I think this was very good showing from the deck. I think this deck can fight with all the like Marvel and Thalidar Guardian combo that goes around just because we have like a lot of interaction. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back for more videos. Who knows, maybe more Pioneer if in the comments you guys like it. And thank you for watching. Remember, this video is offered by ChannelFireball.com, but you can like the video on YouTube and subscribe it on the YouTube channel. And goodbye.